In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to connect an AWS Lambda function to DynamoDB. So the first thing we're going to do is create a table in DynamoDB. So let's first go to our DynamoDB service and create a new table. So this is the DynamoDB AWS console. You can view your tables here. I have a few tables already. This is the dashboard. And there's a button on the dashboard to create a new table. So create a table and name your table. In this example, we're going to have our table called message. And we need to choose the primary key for our message table. In this case, I'm going to have our primary key be a GUID that comes from our request ID. So we're going to call this message ID. And a GUID will be a string. Keep everything else as default and choose create. So here is your new message table. The table name is message. We have our primary key as message ID. Everything here is our table set up with all its details. And this is actually the Amazon resource name. If we were going to restrict our Lambda functions to write to a specific table only, we would need to have this resource name. For our example, we're going to have it be able to write to all tables. So now let's set up our Lambda function. Going back to our AWS Management Console, I'm going to go to our Lambda. So I have some functions already, but we're going to make a new function, and this is going to write a message to our message table. So I'm going to create a function, and it's going to be from scratch, and the function name is going to be write message. And what this function will do is create a new message in our message table on DynamoDB. Our runtime info will be Node.js. So we're going to click create function. So now we have successfully created our new function. It's called write message. This is just the sample Node.js code that Amazon already fills in for us. We're going to change this so that it can write to the DynamoDB, and we're going to just change it within this editor. So the first thing we're going to do is import in the code that we need to so that we can use the Amazon SDK. So we're going to make a const, call this AWS. And we're going to tell it to require the AWS SDK. Then we need to connect to our DynamoDB. So we're going to declare const. This will be called DDB. It's our Dynamo database. Equals new. And then we're going to use our AWS that we created. So new AWS. Dot DynamoDB document client, and then we specify the region our DynamoDB exists in. So in this case, our region is in US East-1. We created it in North Virginia. That is Amazon's US-East-1. So we're going to write in curly bracket region US-East-1, semicolon, and a line break. So now we need to modify our handler to write to DynamoDB. So we have our handler, it's gonna have an async event, and we're going to also add in a context and a callback. Context is the data that's being sent into us, and callback is what's actually going to be returned. We do not need this code. So we're going to write as our message ID a GUID. And what I'm going to use right now is the AWS request ID that is coming in from context. In a production environment, you wouldn't do this. You would normally generate a brand new GUID, but for the sake of this example, we're going to just stick with an easier example. So we're going to just use that request ID. So I'm going to declare const request ID equals context dot AWS request ID. I'm now going to make a new function. Within JavaScript, they work with promises and observables. This function is going to return a promise. So I'm going to make a new function, and I'm going to call this create message. And it will take in the request ID. And what we're going to do is write to the DynamoDB for our table name message. So we're going to set up some parameters that we're going to be passing over. So I like to make const params equals, and we set up our parameters of what we're writing. So the first thing that's expected is the table name. So we say table name, and our table name was message, comma. Then the item, this is what we are writing to the table. So the one thing that is required is the message ID. So message ID, and that will be the request ID. We also want to store a message. So let's say a lowercase message, and we'll write hello from Lambda. Now this would be where you would use your context to get a message that a user sent over. But for the purposes of this tutorial, we're going to stick to it being simple and just hard code it in. This sets up the parameters. Now we need to write it to the database. So in order to write to the database, we will go ddb.put. We pass in the parameters. And we need to return something. So in this case, I want to return a promise. So I'm going to write return ADB put params dot promise. So this is the function that we'll set up to write to our database. Put is going to place those items into our database. Message doesn't exist, but DynamoDB is a NoSQL database. This will be added when we write it to the database. So we need to call create message. So we write await create message. We pass in our request ID. And then we use then. We want to return something. So if it's not an error, we are going to use our callback to return a response. We're going to say callback. It's not an error, so we're going to put a null. And the body will be our status code. So we inserted something into the database, so we're going to return a status code of 201. So status code 201. We're not going to have a body, so it's just going to be an empty body. So body empty. And we want to enable our cross origin cores. So we're going to do headers. And then our access control allow origin will be all. So this is our callback. This will be the response that comes back. What if there's an error? Well, let's handle that as well. So if there's an error, we want to catch the error. So we'll catch specifically a parameter called error, and we are going to write to the console the error. So we're going to write console.error, and we'll write the error message. So this is all the code we need to write to the database, but we are not done yet. If we try to test this code right now, we're going to get rejected when writing to DynamoDB. So if I make a test, we can just use this sample one. test. We don't need anything in our body. So I'm going to create this. So make sure we save and then let's test. And we get an error back saying our access was denied for our role write message. So let's edit our write message role so that we can write to the DynamoDB. We're going to scroll up, go to permissions. We're going to click our write message role, and this will open up our write message role. And with that, we have a policy. This is the AWS basic execution roles. And what we want to do is add on to this. So we're going to edit this policy. We'll click edit policy, add additional permissions. We're going to choose a service. We're going to choose DynamoDB. And in this example, we're going to give permission to write to all tables on our DynamoDB. So all DynamoDB accesses, we want it to read, write, scan. And with that, we need to give it permission to all resources. Now, if we want it to restrict it, we can restrict it down to a specific table. And that's when, if we go back to our DynamoDB, you would need your information of your ARN or Amazon resource name. And that's where you can restrict it to only being able to query one table. Going back to our permissions here, I'm going to say all resources. So this is set up completely. And we're going to say review policy. There's our DynamoDB with full access to all resources. We're going to click save changes. It has been updated now with DynamoDB. So let's go back to our write message Lambda function and let's test it again and see if it succeeds. So we're going to click test and we get back the status code is 201 and it all successful. Let's go over to our DynamoDB, go to items tab. We can refresh this view and there is our message. Hello from Lambda. So now we've learned how to write to a DynamoDB. Let's learn how to read from the DynamoDB. I'm going back to Lambda and I'm going to make a new Lambda function. And this is going to be called readMessage. So create function, readMessage, and we create our function. Now the setup for reading from our data from our database is going to be very similar to writing to our database minus how we query the information. So let's copy from the other area where we declared our AWS and DDB. I'm going to add that to the top of our index.js. And now we need to modify our export. So exports.handler, we're going to take the exact same async signature that we used earlier. So that's events, context, and callback. Now, what we need to do is create a method that scans our database. In this case, we are going to call our DynamoDB and just get back 10 of the messages in the database, if there is 10. We're going to make a method. I'm going to remove this code. We're going to write await, and this will be called read. Message. It will take no parameters and we're going to have our, it's going to be a promise. So we'll have our then that will return back some form of data, which will be what we're querying. Otherwise it'll have an error. So then whatever we're going to do, otherwise we catch our error and we'll do the same thing we did in the last example. So we'll log the error. So console.error. So let's define the function read message. Function read message. No parameters. And our parameters are going to be similar to our create message. So I'm actually going to use the exact same parameters. That is const param. I'm having my table name message. I'm not inserting any items, but we're going to be using a limit. So limit 10. Now I'm going to call DynamoDB and scan the database. So this is going to return ddb.scan, passing in our params, .promise. So this is going to return back data this time. So this will have a list of items that we are going to output. So we're going to say data.items. These are the items being returned for each. We'll make a function item. This is the code block. We'll do console.log. And we'll say item.message. This would be for the one item that we have in the table. It would say hello from Lambda. So let's save this. If we run this code right now, the Lambda function does not have the correct permissions, the role that the Lambda function is executing on. So let's change our role. So let's scroll up. Let's go to our permissions. And we can either update this read message to have permissions to read from the DynamoDB, or we can edit our execution role and choose our write message role. So let's choose write message and we'll hit save. And now our read message and write message are executing under the same role. So if we test our function, we get our results back. We're not returning anything with our callback, but we log hello from Lambda. So now you've learned how to read from DynamoDB. So you might be saying, wait a minute, I don't want to just log it to the console. I want the response to come back through our API. Well, let's modify our callback. So I'm going to do callback. This is when it is successful. So we'll have our null and then defining our body. So in this case, our status code should be 200. It's successful, but we didn't insert anything into the database. So we'll say status code 200. The body is going to be the items in our database that we are returning back. So we'll say body data.items, because that's what we're doing here. We're doing our data.items for each and we're logging them. Now, our data items is what's going to be our body, and we add our headers. So headers, I'm just going to copy it from our other Lambda function. So, headers, there's our access control origins for all. So click save, and let's test this. We get our test, and now we have our response with each message in there. If there's multiple message, this will be curly brackets, comma, and then the next message. So congratulations, you have learned how to read and write to DynamoDB using AWS Lambda functions.